Good morning, wherever you are and wherever you're watching from. Thank you very much for being here. I really appreciate you. Just a quick reminder, hit that like, hit subscribe if you're not already, and join me on this journey. Today is a bit of a different video. I've done a bit of true crime at the moment. I am fascinated by Alex Murdoch and his the accusations against him. You can check that out on my true crime playlist. Normally I talk about creativity and its benefits on health, mental health, physical health, everything, celebrating creativity in all of its forms, because I am a big champion of that. I know how much it's helped me. Today though is a bit of a warts and all video, because I think it's important. If I'm going to talk about all of those things, I think it's really important that people see that I come from a place of experience. I think it's really important for other people to see that they're not alone, or for people who don't struggle with invisible illnesses, to learn from it. It's really easy to identify or empathize with someone who has a broken leg. Even if we've never broken a leg, we can imagine just how painful that is and how much of a pain in the backside it is to get around in a cast. We can. It's a lot harder with invisible illnesses. Now, as you can see from my face, I've been covering this up with makeup. It is all part of one of the new diagnoses. Obviously, I've been living with this for a little while, only recently diagnosed, and although it doesn't change any of the symptoms, it gives me context, and it gives me ideas on how to help myself. This is caused by EDS. My skin is super stretchy, but it's also really fragile, so it splits open really easily. It's usually around my knuckles or my hands, sometimes my face, as you can see, and it takes forever to heal. The lack of collagen in my skin and bones, skin and cartilage and everywhere else in my body, just means that cuts and scrapes and bruises take forever to heal. I also bruise really easily. My legs are covered in bruises right now, because I can just tap myself, and I've got a massive purple bruise. It's ridiculous. So all of this gives me context, and it gives me a chance to try new things. So at the moment I have supports on both of my knees, one around my hips. I have compression gloves for my hands, and it makes me feel like I'm giving into it, or I'm making a big deal of it, because you can see those things. There's a lot of guilt associated with it. There's a lot of depression, especially at the moment. I'm in pain all of the time. It feels like I am trapped in a body that hates me. And I'm sure there are plenty of people who can identify with this, whether you have the same conditions or not. There is a huge amount of guilt that today is a bad day and I can't do everything that I did yesterday, or that I have to pace myself because we've got a bunch of stuff happening this afternoon, or whatever it might be. And there are days where I go to bed really upset that I haven't been the best person I could be because of the illness, because of the depression that it causes. And I have PTSD and physical health issues, and they bounce off of each other. If I'm depressed or stressed or anxious, that makes my physical health worse. If my physical health is bad, then I get depressed and anxious and all of those things, and it becomes this trigger, because medical stuff is part of the complex PTSD, having to justify myself or explain myself over and over, feeling like I'm not being listened to with my health, is all part of that. So they bounce off of each other. And I have bad days. And I'm going to be honest, this is a bad day. And what makes it worse is having to explain to other people what is going on. People who know me, people who I feel should know this stuff. And I have to remind myself that you can connect with someone's symptoms and health on an intellectual level, but not necessarily connect with it on an emotional level, or not forget, but not really think forward when you're saying stuff. So, you know, instead of when someone says, you know, how are you doing today, or how are you feeling, it puts you in a position of having to list what's going on with you. Whereas if someone said to me, what's the pain level like today? That's a more useful way of phrasing things, because I can put a number to it, or a label, you know, I'm uncomfortable, or I'm in pain, or whatever. That is much easier. Having to list and then justify what's going on with your body or your brain today is really hard. So, you know, what level are you at today is a lot more helpful to me. And I'd love to know whether that would be more helpful to anyone watching who has mental or physical health issues. You don't have to do that publicly. Leave a comment if you want. If not, you can email me at craftalytical@gmail.com, and I will discuss that anonymously, not using your name. Because there are some phrases that annoy me. You know, someone saying, well, you've got to push through. I've had a doctor recently tell me to keep busy because you forget about the pain. Forgetting that when you stop being busy, that pain kicks in. Yes, I can ignore the pain while I'm busy and I'm doing things and I'm on my feet and I'm running around after the kids or the dog or whatever else. But as soon as I sit down, that pain hits, and it is 10 times worse than it would have been if I had paced myself. But they're also saying to pace myself. How do you keep busy and pace yourself at the same time? You can't. Modern life doesn't give you that ability. There's still laundry that needs to be done. There's still dishes that need to be done. There's, you know, I've got to clean out the fridge because we've got shopping coming. All of those things need to be done regardless of how I feel. There is no pacing myself in this modern life. And I know I'm not alone in feeling that way. If you have answers to this, if you have anything that works for you, I don't want advice on, have you tried not being ill? Have you tried essential oils? I mean people who live with this or live with invisible illnesses coming forward and saying, this phrase is helpful to me, or doing things this way, explaining things this way. I find that helpful. I use spoon theory an awful lot, and that works to a certain extent. But it's like anything, if you overuse it, it just loses meaning for the person that you're talking to. And I have found that, you know, I don't have the energy for these conversations. I don't have the spoons for this kind of conversation over and over. And when I say that, the other person often just thinks I'm being pissy. And I'm not. I am just explaining where I'm at. And I would really like to reach out to people who want to learn about this kind of thing. Ask me questions. Let's have an honest conversation about what it's like to live with invisible illnesses, what it's like to be judged for how your face looks without kind of any thinking forward from the person who's doing that judging. Because education is key. Ableism is one of those things that is so pervasive that people don't realize they're doing it. People don't realize they're dismissing what it feels like to be in pain 24 hours a day, to not get good sleep, to be forced into routines that don't fit how your body works. And I think the more we ask questions from people who can have those conversations, that do have the energy to have those conversations, the more we learn and the more we help. So if there is something you want to ask, if you are like me and struggling with mental and physical health stuff, let me know, talk to me, ask your questions, or tell me what would be useful to you in the comments or via email. That's craftalytical@gmail.com, and we'll make it part of the conversation. Let's open this up. For me, that is really useful. It's a way of getting rid of the ableism, because it's out there. I experience it pretty much every day, and it's not useful to anyone. No one is moving forward. So, warts and all, let's be honest. Next time, I hope I will be having a better day. Right now, I am exhausted and I'm in pain, and I just want to curl up and forget the world exists, and I can't because of that. I will speak to you soon. Thank you for being here.